Boljoon is a fifth-class municipality situated in the southeastern coast of the province of Cebu and is about 103 kilometers from Cebu City. Boljoon derived its name from the town's peculiar appearance. In Cebuano, the municipality is called Bulho, which is a large landmass cavity surrounded by mountains or a valley brought about by the sudden collapse of a mountain range. Boljoon is one of the oldest towns in the southern part of the province. It is noted for its most quaint and picturesque terrain. Its narrow coastal plains are bordered by the cliffs and the luxuriant hills, which have a commanding view of the Bohol Strait. Being a coastal town, Boljoon features several alluring beach lines, particularly notable the Club Fort Med and Medyong Seaside Escape. Also, the local government of Boljoon, in partnership with the Coastal Resource Management Project, established the Granada and Arbor Marine Sanctuaries.
Niata karon sa among gitawag o Granada Marine Sanctuary. Pag establish ining Marine Sanctuary dinhi sa Granada, nagsugod gid siya atong gitawag na mo o Coastal Resource Management Program. Katong programa ha, usa to siya ka kalihukan nga mura bitaw og nag-design unsaon pag-improve sa among coastal resources dinhi sa Boljoon. So ang una namong gibuhat, among gihimuan og kanang gitawag og participatory coastal resource assessment nga among gihimuan og baseline data unsa naman ang kahimtang sa among kadagatan. Ug dito napakita nga grabe na ang pagkagusbat sa among mga coastal resources, ang among mga gasang nangagupok na tungod sa mga illegal fishing methods, ang among mga seagrasses habitat doon na ikadao tungod sa another illegal fishing methods, o ingon man sa among mga mangroves. Unya, katong coastal participatory coastal resource assessment, among gipong gikuha unsa man ka ang posibleng paagi nga mauli-ulian ang among mga daot ng mga kadagatan. Unya, usa sa girekomendar sa mga technical person atong panahon na doon na may partner ng NGO itong gitawag o Coastal Education Foundation. Unya, sila mo ay nagrekomendar nga the only way to restore what has been damaged by our coastal resources is to establish a marine sanctuary. Pero ang paghimo o Marine Sanctuary dili sayon kay kinahanglan makakuha ka ng gitawag og community acceptance, social acceptance sa Luise nga ang mga tao bitaw mo dawat sa project nga ilang proyekto dili lang kay project sa LGU. So taas ang kutay sa mga consultation nga gihimo including asa mang dapita ibutang kay kini siyang Granada Marine Sanctuary ikaduha na lang ni siya sa site. Kay ang usa nga gibasihan sa pag-establisar og usa ka marine sanctuary kana mang posible pa bitawng maulian ang usa ka lugar kun ang usa ka lugar gani wa nagipag-asa di gina pwede himo ni mong usa ka protected area kun dili ato pa mga lugar nga potential pa dibilopon ang original na mo nga site kana untang lugar diha oh kay naa diha ang makita nimo nga buhi pa kaayo ang mga kuan mga corals mga seagrasses and then mga unay mga mangroves ingon ana nga component sa usa ka ecosystem habitat pero ang nakapasuo lang kay mura bitaw og it used to be a fishing ground sa among mga fisher folks niya ang ilang mangong perception og maghimo ta og marine sanctuary ato silang gikawatan og lugar nga ilang kapanagatan niya kay kinahanglan man gyud na base sa resulta sa among baseline survey kinahanglan man gyud nga mo establisar mi og kanang gitawag og marine protected area mao nga sa sabot-sabot sa mga kanang community resident diri instead nga kadtong dunay daghang managat nga lugar dinhi na lang ibutang sa kanang Granada Marine Sanctuary kaning present site nato karon kay nakit-an man sad sa mga technical person nga sikan option siya nga bayab pahimuon ang usa ka proyekto sa MPA.
The town also has a rich cultural heritage with its well-preserved historical landmarks such as Old Church, Town Plaza, and Church Cemetery. Numerous antique houses can also be found all over town. An antique house owner also shared with us their family story.
Missionary ay 1928 din natukod. Tawag niya, mura niya siya gihimong magsakuan pa mag-convention ari diri kay he's a part of the 1935 Constitutional Convention.
I also had the opportunity to visit the oldest resident of Boljoon at 93 years old and got a chance to briefly talk to Ms. Sestoso.
Ibuot niya ba rin pag gobernador siyo ni Cirilo? Karon kato pare kani ato wala mo may balong kato ng pare kani ato mumayaw sa lungsod mumansin mga hari-hari
sabay mayor mas mayor
mayor muto pirmi si mo ani sa ako sungkuran at giyain eh kaya mang iistorya aparte in lungsod.
Our visit to Boljoon is not complete without exploring not just the coastal side of the town but also the rugged mountains as well. I was surprised to discover in our trip with our guide Mia of Cebuano Tours that there's a pleasant mountain surprise waiting for us.
Right behind me is the coastal town of Boljoon with the cliff that is the most photographed cliff of this particular town. And this 12-kilometer stretch brings you to Palanas Mountain Resort and Farm, which is a well-paved road heading to the interior part of the town of Boljoon.
Traversing for close to 30 minutes in a well-paved but narrow road from the main highway of this town, we drove up to one of the most beautiful driving spots in southern Cebu. It is at this time we discovered and set foot in Palanas Mountain Farm and Resort. While inside the farm, a variety of leisure activities await you that include trekking, fishing, swimming, visiting the mini zoo, or simply enjoying the bounty of the farm prepared in home-style cooking while basking in the fresh and rejuvenating mountain air. One of the oldest towns indeed I have visited in numerous travels, and as we headed home, I felt again after a long time a nostalgic feeling on the town's rich culture and history, but more importantly, a feeling on how we can preserve for the next generation to see and appreciate the town of Boljoon and our country, the Philippines. Make My Trip Travel TV would like to thank Cebuano Tours.